their experience is better than technique. It is better than refined artistry. It is a lifetime of experience that actually, when they move, even when moving can be difficult, it reminds you of where they've been, how they've been, what they've been through, what they've experienced. And in a work like that, that is actually what we're trying to achieve. I say there's no sinner like an old sinner. I think the reason I keep coming back to this troupe of dancers down in Tasmania, apart from the fact that Tasmania drags me back anyway, is they offer me something that no other company I've worked with does. It's a troupe of mature artists, but it's a troupe of very adventurous women for the rage. And I think they are completely courageous, because some of the things I've asked them to do, I don't think I would get the same response if I was working with professional dancers or actors or singers. They bring such a unique slant to everything they do, and they bring such a courageous energy. I think professional dancers would probably faint if I actually asked them to do some of the things I'm asking these girls to do.
So these are the hand shoes only. They get really dirty on this floor, and if they're put on top of each other from the base, from the bottom, to the canvas, it dirties.
And I think sometimes it's hard for them. I think sometimes they feel uncomfortable. But I'm not asking them to be technical ballerinas. I'm asking them to be involved in the creation, to bring their wisdom and their age to the event, and what they know about the world and what they know about sin.
And should we keep the laces tight?
In 2016, at the end of the season of the frock, we'd packed up the frock and put it back in its wardrobe. And Graham rang and said he would really like to work with Maid again. And the topic was he would like to be able to use the wonderful sculptures of Judith Wright, who has depicted seven of the sins. And he said, I would love to come and work with Maid again.
Janet and I have a friend who dates back to our Australian ballet earliest days, who was a dancer with us and is now a great artist, sculptor, video art. We love her work, and I'd seen some of her interactive installations. She mentioned that she had an installation that had been created on the Seven Deadly Sins. And although we haven't had them at this point in time, we've seen the photos, and her works always seem to incorporate some theatrical, dancey element. It's something that I think once a dancer, it never leaves you.
Can I see those walks that you did? And then remember that any case, we were doing walk, 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 and we were doing circles around corners.
That's what we were particularly doing from this, Graham, from around Ashka.
Yes, and you make them meaningful by following with your focus and engaging all your body when you do those things. Getting into your walk, that's lovely, clump. It's nice you can hear a rhythm too. This is free fall all around, turning corners. I love it. And that has to be slow and even and contacting. So be there ready, and there, be there ready.
Point them in the same direction.
Parallel, absolute parallel. Be accurate, babies. Toe to toe. Bringing it back that way, so it's making a circle. Can we do this? Quarter, turn, quarter. So it goes up, And coming down at 10 inches a quarter, slowly. And one last one. And number five was become the throw. Love your work.
The technical side, Graham works around extremely well. Some people in the ensemble have never learned dance before. For example, Supi.
Supi, can you do this with your shoes? And just join into that. So you've just increased it to six and stay with her for a while.
She brings a certain elegance, a certain honesty to her performances.
I enjoy working with the maid group. They're all a great load of people. We work well together. And I think because we've been working for such a time together, we can almost see what another person is doing. And you can react to that quite nicely.
It almost needs to be up, down, change, and up, down, change, and that could be even.
That was not too bad for a first time, I thought.
Yeah, I
thought so. Remember, we've got to do all these things. We've got to keep them slightly apart, and we're moving, and up, and up. Moving.
Good girls.
And up. I thought that was pretty good.
That was pretty good.
It was my path.
Yeah, your path was great.
There's a lot of research now around being physically active as we approach 60s, 70s, mid-70s in some cases, that being physically active is important, but also the creative side, thinking through, it changes the pathways in the brain.
It's an atmospheric work, and what I want to bring to it is not literal. It's not about the individual sins, but somehow that topic has got them absolutely fired up.
You can just feel isolated and envy anyone who has friends.
So I am really just reading this.
You're reading
two of the room.
It,
oh, God. Is that what you're talking about?
Another one.
Okay, right. Growing up, Paul was okay. Everyone was the same, apart from the girl across the road. She was my best friend most of the time and said she envied me, my brothers and sisters, and she wished her mother stayed home. But I really envied her. We were asked by Graham to choose a sin, so I was away at the time and I thought, oh, I'll be given something I don't want, and I don't want any of the sins. So I started to look at them very closely and read about them, and I found the antidote or the other side of each sin in some website, and one of them was kindness. The sin of envy is removed by kindness. When her doting parents gave her a handsome pony for her 11th birthday, my envy reached mammoth proportions. After that, every waking moment was spent on how to get a horse.
A horse, her horse. Good.
I schemed and bargained and begged and whined. I worked hard for pocket money. So I wrote a little story about being a very lucky girl and being gifted a poor old horse when I was 13, which was a really clever thing for my parents to do. This horse, when she came out of that horse fight, was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen.
She wasn't.
She was terrible.
The
she
white,
was
the white
dirty.
Pony, the white
and she
pony
was
over the road was going.
However, her poor, sore legs introduced me to the country vet. He was almost too old for me. Or so his mother said, but I snagged him anyway.
Turns out he's the kindest man in the world. We have six grandchildren now. Should I be looking down?
No.
It's the kindest man in the world. We have six grandchildren now.
Okay.
The contrast of all the sins and the consequence and the redemption of anger and wrath, or many of them just, or in the course of this experience, we're going into beautiful softness and comfort and things, because I think as humans, there's a point when you want to fix the wrongs of the world. I would like you to aim more central, because I don't want them to go too wide into sculptures. So, bullseye.
Yeah, I'm just wondering whether...
Bad. That would... Chrissy died. Fabulous. No, you don't get seconds. Everything in this work has been pulled out of the ether in a way, and that's what's so beautiful.
Basketballer, you want to be the tall guy. Wow!
But I can find rage in the throwing of the shoes, but I can also find, you know, a very Arabic offence, throwing shoes, an ultimate sort of statement of despising. Lots of little elements just keep growing out of nowhere.
I love it in the shoes.
I think this is one of those works that you can just let instinct and emotion and internalized things manifest.
Because this is all in silence, it would really be nice to have one section that is really percussive. Because the noise is really... Love it.
That's good. Fabulous. Mm.
I do love the thing of trying to...
People might love.
And like, headbutt them. Hello. Oh. Yeah.
That's it.
Yes, that little hover at the top is beautiful. Stamina, yeah?
We are not professional dancers, so sometimes he needs to adjust to accommodate what we can and can't physically do. But also, he's very cheeky sometimes, so it would be, oh, Graham, you can't say that, or Graham, no, you can't do that. And we all just laugh and then move on.
That's a Graham Murphy toilet roll ballet that you've got to deal with. Roll up your pubic hair and put it in your false purse and your false groin. And then you just lift the
ball. I love the noise. One.
Oh my god, that's really
cool.
One.
Whoa, we got a lot out. Yay!
Success. Oh, this is worth celebrating.
We didn't meet Ken.
Oh. Girls couldn't do anything.
And I almost feel like, as long as you don't get strangled by this,
yeah, well,
I almost feel like this is just drifting around you in horror, and you are just
caught up in it. Yeah. We go back.
And rather than, but once someone on one end's taken it, should be no problem. And then the next bit, and then you've just tangled into the web of her pubic hair. Loving that. And then from here you look at her. And then you make your position.
I think I'm a rather shy person, but I looked at Janet, and when she said that this is okay, I trust them both. I trust Graham and Janet that this is a good thing to do. And you know, when I'm on stage, I'm someone else, and I'm not afraid of people laughing at me, so I like to make people happy and smiling, so for me it is good.
Yeah, that's lovely. So, yeah, beautiful.
This is what I like to do. I like performing. I was a Polish folk dancer, and I know in Poland you stop at a certain age dancing, so I thought, okay, I will do ballroom dancing, or maybe I will do flamenco, but in here I got such a great opportunity to be in dance theatre. I love it.
I wonder if you should leave the case open so you can put things when you finish with them that way, and then you're feeling that beautiful, and then you find a tough little bit. Oh, do you think fingernails is quite nice? Just fingernails?
I'm vanity, so my husband told me that Graham knows me very well.
Closer, closer, closer. I love it.
I love the face going.
What the?
We definitely grow. There's definitely a challenge. There's definitely people saying, I can't do that at the beginning, and then realising afterwards that, yes, I have done it.
And you stay where you are, they'll start it, and now go with them. And right across, and you stay where you are, and they're going to go, go.
It's not a theatre stage performance. It's a performance where audience is very close. They're walking around as maid. It's not a dance company that dances in theatres as much. We like to go and be unique. We like close proximity to audiences, and Graham's accommodating that, particularly in Seven Deadly Sins.
This is probably going to push people around the outside, and we might be sort of end up doing it this way too. It's just that Rockabye Baby motion is so nice. Attach everything, sew the doona into the thing, leave that bit of gap, which is great.
Oh, I chose sloth because it's my natural inclination to lie on the couch and read books. That's where I feel really comfortable.
Yeah, I love. It's beautiful. And spin your legs up.
Not too fast.
I love change. The worming change position is beautiful. And rolling.
Take time on that one, Shirley, if it's not too painful.
I think that sloth is a wonderful, that sort of letting go of everything. How bad can that be? I know it's terrible if you don't actually occasionally get up and do something for the world or yourself. I think they're all fabulous. So I look at all the sins and I think, you know, well, don't feel too bad if you've got all seven, because quite frankly, that can be quite motivating.
I think I'm probably a general sinner. I seem to do bits of everything. It's interesting, very interesting. I think we have all sinned in some way.
Lovely.
Maybe not gross sins, but I'm sure we have all had a lust after something. We've all had I want that. I think we've all got pride in something in our lives that we've done.
And these ladies relish their wrinkles and they delight in their dreams, and they take you somewhere that you would normally maybe not have the courage to go. Don't know where the results end up. I feel like it is the strangest work I've ever done. Sometimes in the first week I went, I think I'm taking the wrong approach. I am treating this like theatre, and I have to treat them like actual elements of Judith's creation. They're like extensions of the sculptures that line the room, the seven constructions that she's put together.
That's lots of.
No, this is envy. That's okay. Out there.
Good.
Back pink face there. Where do we want? What's this one?
Feel about today?
I'm feeling excited. I think it'll be great. It's actually the culmination of the best exciting time in working in a project, you know, because the last 2 weeks and the creative development is what the experience is all about for us.
I can't say that I really enjoy performing. It gives me a deal of satisfaction when it's all done. I love getting the performance established, but I get absolutely petrified before going on stage.
Sorry, if you feel happy to be upstanding, please do, and anyone who really needs to sit should have a seat. Be kind to them.
It's 20 past, still got lots of time. Everybody got enough blood on their chests?
Yes. Yeah.
That was interesting that we throw it from down here.
Yeah.
Thank you for being here, because you are our first experience of the first stage of this adventure. You'll be seeing something which is quite strange to do that has no soundtrack, for the most part. So time is very bendy when there's no music. There is nothing to contain these girls. So if it goes on for 5.5 hours, now a warning, just bear with us. And just, seriously, that's something to consider. It has a certain power because there is no music and there is no pulse and there is no drive except their heartbeat, their energy and their passion. Here we go, gang.
When she got too old and too lame, we sent her to the country as a broodmare. However, her poor, sore legs introduced me to the country vet. He was almost too old for me, or so his mother said, but I snagged him anyway.
Turns out, he's the kindest man in the world. We have 6 grandchildren now. Thank you.
I keep reminding myself, this is stage one. There'll be another rehearsal. There'll be a rehearsal period in situ, in the real venue, with the real sculpture. So we are so lucky to have this, so honoured actually to have an audience.